Women have a higher risk of developing dementia compared to men. In fact, approximately 2/3 of Americans who have dementia are women. Why is this? In today's video, I want to share with you 5 potential reasons women develop dementia more than men. This is certainly a field that receives research attention. They're still not exactly sure on all of the different factors, but here are the 5 factors that continue to show up in research. Number 1 is longevity, meaning women live longer than men, and age is the biggest risk factor for dementia. So that means the longer you live, the higher your risk of developing dementia. And because women live longer, more of them develop dementia. That one's pretty simple. The other potential reason is the role that genetics play. So we know that the APOE4 gene places somebody at higher risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. And for some reason, women who carry this gene have a higher risk of developing Alzheimer's compared to men who carry that same gene. The reason for this difference is unclear. It's thought that possibly there are hormonal factors that can play into this reason, which brings me to reason number 3, which has to do with hormonal changes. When women experience menopause, it means their estrogen decreases, and estrogen actually has some neuroprotective factors. It's possible that the loss of estrogen is increasing women's risk for developing Alzheimer's disease. The 4th possible reason that women experience higher rates of Alzheimer's compared to males have to do with heart health. We know that heart health is important for both male and females, and people who have heart issues are at a greater risk of dementia. However, for females in particular, there are some different things going on in the body that makes them particularly at a higher risk. For example, women actually have a higher rate of developing high blood pressure after menopause. High blood pressure is a risk factor for dementia. We also know that women who have diabetes have a higher rate of developing heart-related issues compared to men who have diabetes, and both diabetes and heart-related issues are risk factors for dementia. Cholesterol is an important factor when it comes to developing dementia, and we know that females after menopause start to experience an increase in the bad cholesterol levels, a decrease in the good cholesterol levels that will increase their dementia risk. We know smoking is a risk factor, but for whatever reason, smoking negatively impacts females more and leads to what we would consider hardening of the arteries, and that is a risk factor for dementia. So although the 4th reason that increases a female's risk has to do with these heart-related issues, it's entangled with all of these other conditions as well. But here's the 5th and final reason: social and lifestyle factors. Women are more likely to experience things like anxiety, depression, and loneliness, which can lead to greater risk for dementia. We also know that females happen to be more of the caregivers, and caregivers often experience a significant amount of stress, anxiety, sleep-related problems. I imagine that is also increasing to their dementia risk, although the research that I saw did not specifically mention females being more often the caregivers as one of the reasons, but I believe that it's one of the reasons. I've linked a bunch of the articles that I used in reference for this video in the description below if you'd like to take a look at what the research shows yourself and dive deeper into all of the details. And here's the thing: taking care of brain health is important regardless of your gender. Male or female, it's super important to do what we can to keep our brains as healthy as possible. I've linked some videos below in the description that can help you do that. If you found this video helpful and you'd like more information, you can click the red subscribe button on your screen. It's totally free. It'll let you know when I post new videos. And if you have any questions or comments that you'd like to see me do a future video on, you can leave that in the comment below. As always, if you're interested in joining an amazing supportive community where we come together to talk about how do we take care of ourselves and how do we take care of our loved ones in the best way possible, you can consider joining us inside of our care course, where we come together every week to provide support, care, ideas, strategies, approaches to help make getting through this caregiving journey as easy and as joyful as possible. All right, I'm sending you so much love. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.